This is my robotics team, and this is our robot. And after narrowly losing our last competition, we're here at Friendswood to run it back. And this time, we were going to win. So for those who aren't familiar, in a nutshell, these robots are built by teams of high school students, and this year we're competing to get as many of these orange rings as possible into these scoring areas. We play in teams of three called alliances, and the team with the most points wins. So you guys know the drill. We show up, do some practice matches, prep and adjust some settings, and it's off to the qualification matches. And I have to say, it was not going well. The settings we adjusted didn't actually help. Instead, they caused our robot's intake to float about an inch off the ground when fully deployed, making it unable to pick up any rings from the floor. Once we fixed that issue though, we encountered more intake problems as our grip tape wore off and we lacked enough traction to pick up the ring. As a result, we were in 30th place at the event, with only 1 out of 5 matches we played being wins. But we weren't giving up just yet, and after finally fixing all of our issues, it was time to make the greatest comeback in our career. So we ended the day in 7th place, thanks to our good matchups and pre-match strategizing. We also got a 4-note Auton path perfected and the robot was driving perfectly. With that, we prepared for day 2 with 3 matches left to finalize our ranks.
Day 2, what score, what rank are we going to get?
0.
0.
1.
Well, first place wasn't quite possible, but getting 2 and maintaining a spot in the top 5 was, as we had some pretty promising alliance members in our remaining matches. And I'll show you how those went. In Qual's match 53, we hit our perfect 4-note Auton, giving us a 10-point lead over the Red Alliance, and setting us up for the Melody ranking bonus, which we got from the help of our teammates. And by some miracle, a red robot hit our teammate on the stage during the endgame portion of the match, giving us an extra 10 stage points, which gave us a whopping 4 rank points. For Qual's match 60, we put up a good fight, getting one more rank point, but ultimately lost because our teammate didn't pick the right Auton, moving us down to 6th place. But we still had a shot at redemption for our final match, where we were paired with Team 231, the current 2nd seed team. Thanks to this great matchup, we secured both the Melody and Ensemble rank points. This not only propelled us back into 4th place for our final rank, but also caused a shakeup in the leaderboards, with High Voltage now seeding above the previous number 1 seed, the Robonauts. And with ranks being locked in, it was off to alliance selection, where the top 8 teams at the competition get to build the permanent alliance for the rest of the event. Seeing as we were potentially going to be alliance captains, we were aiming to pick up Team 324 chips. But, by some miracle, 231 High Voltage ended up picking 9128 Itcon Robotics, which was the team 118 wanted to recruit. And this happened.
118 would love to add some energy to your alliance with 5892.
5892, I think they like that idea.
Before we dive into the playoffs, let me explain our strategy. In this game, the main way to get notes is to travel all the way over to the opposite side of the field and get them from the source. But that takes a very long time, and we want to score as many notes as possible in a short time frame. So, our plan is to have our team and the Robonauts shuttle notes to our amp zone, while Bluetonium defends the notes from being stolen by the enemy team. Once the notes have piled up, we amplify our speaker and score them all as fast as possible for over double the points. Now you know the game plan, let's continue.
This is our year.
This is our year.
This is our year.
This is our year.
Let's get it.
I bought for 16 passenger. This a G5. No, this not a Challenger. Big one. I keep some members with me in the fridge. Get cold seats. They some cannibals. Eaters. They like to geek. Drink a whole bottle. Wake up and repeat. She took a look. Mixed it with the chill out. Now she said 3D.
Well, here we are again. Just one match away from the finals. And once more facing off against the number 1 alliance for that coveted guaranteed spot in the finals. And we weren't going home just yet.
Okay, this is number 1 versus number 2.
Drivers behind your lines. 3, 2, 1, crescendo! This one's gonna be close. That's a heck of a match.
At the end of the match, we had a slight lead, but Red had 3 robots on the chain, while we only had 2, and the scores could go either way. And with bated breath, we waited for the result.
We in finals, baby! We in finals, baby! We in finals, baby!
We did it. We were finally in the running for our first blue banner in 4 years, and it could not have been done without our amazing alliance members and our incredible team. While we were preparing to potentially face the number one alliance again in the finals, Alliance 3 actually managed to strategize and beat Alliance 1 in the lower bracket, meaning that finals were going to be between Alliance number 2 and Alliance number 3. The first alliance to 2 wins, wins the event. With 1 win under our belt, we just needed 1 more to take home that banner. And with it being the match point, to showcase our gracious professionalism between alliances, we did an air high five? I don't know, this event was kind of wacky, we just went with it. But now it's time. The match began smoothly, and we started with a slight lead over Alliance 3 with 5 notes in our speaker and only 4 in theirs. And at the start of tele-up, we began to shuttle notes to the Robonauts for them to score later. But just then, disaster struck. We hit the stage hard, and due to a weak battery connection, our battery was entirely disconnected, and we were disabled for the rest of the match. This gave the Blue Alliance the chance they needed to catch up, and it was getting close. But, the Robonauts being the Robonauts and Bluetonium defending the collected notes, they managed to keep up, but we weren't sure if it was enough. And the results were in. This win meant so much to us, as the core team had been working so hard since the start of 2022 to build the team from the ground up, and to see it pay off was just absolutely incredible. With that said, our next stop is the Texas District State Championship, so if you guys want to see how we do there, subscribe for the next video coming out very soon. Sweet.